starting with Fox and Friends, and you can't stop me. The Fox and the Friends.
Statue of Freedom. The dome is made of cast iron and it weighs 8 million pounds. As we look live on this Tuesday, on the 10th, 2021,
hot cup on the organic. Got Ducey. Ainsley. And Cummy. Cummy's crack up. Secrets, so to speak. But not, I don't know about an all precincts. Some precincts were probably all the cops. All of the cops. Maybe some precincts were all the cops. It's probably a number they're all corrupt because they probably cycle in new people from time to time. So that's pretty rare. They're just all shit cops.
The police are firing back, but they're not putting down their badges. They're told not to do their job, and now they're backing off. And we're seeing crime just take over all these major cities, small towns and big towns. In every major city, it is up, and the cops are beginning to show their anger.
Every major city is up. Why don't they show us? Why don't they, you know, how hard would it be to... Now he's looking down around like... I guess there's sort of a schism with the Democratic Party. So some people want to defund the police. Some people don't. The Republicans are taking that. She might be a lesbian too. If she's a black Democrat lesbian, then that's like the Fox News trifecta. Like, stick it into hate.
outside on the street level.
I'll never ever be a fan if you're a black crime
guy. Well, what they will tell you over and over again, cops, that when you set the tone of cops are the problem, and we're not going to prosecute crime, it turns into chaos on the streets. Chicago Alderman Randy Lopez says the mayor's office is really making things dangerous and is tangentially responsible for the violence they're witnessing in that city that seems overrun right now. Back to the matter that the 38 officers shot at in the city of Chicago since Lori Lightfoot has been mayor this year alone. We had Ella French, who was gunned down and viciously murdered this past weekend.
There's a lot of people there. It's a big city.
The lesson that we've learned is that the only thing more dangerous than the gangbangers and criminals on the streets of the city of Chicago is Mayor Lori Lightfoot.
People are messed up in the head. This is a full on propaganda hippies.
She is, as you said, an absolute failure. And he's a Democrat. Officer French, you know, is the first person to die in the line of duty during the tenure of Mayor Lightfoot. There she is right there. Yesterday, David Brown, who is the police superintendent for Chicago, said the people of Chicago need to pray
not only
for the
entire story,
officer who is fighting for his life, but also for the officers on the street doing their job. He said the police have little support from the public and members of the media who often focus on police reform issues and not acts of heroism, he said. It's past time to stop this. They have dark alleys, none of you will go down to protect.
Responsible for this mystery, I'm responsible for everything that happens. And we can save a few lives, we can save the help of some kids. It's worth whatever trouble I'm getting. And that's kind of this whole issue of local control. We know what's happening in our community better. So this is not something that we're defying the state just because it's what it is. It's because it's a need. And as soon as we
are wearing a mask, and I can't understand very well. We're trying to normalize people talking in masks and seeing them.
Quarantining again and working and doing school from home.
COVID surge in Florida. They're putting down Florida.
Well, I think especially in Florida, we're back to having to employ a bunch of strategies. We're pretty well vaccinated in Orange County, but once you leave into rural parts, the numbers are dramatically different. So there's a lot of risk there. Quite honestly, I think we're back to considering social distancing. We're back to considering outdoor versus indoor spaces. People should be contemplating masks where appropriate. And certainly, we should all be more cognizant of who we're with in relation to their vaccination status.
I don't look at this number, but it says there's 166,354,374 people vaccinated, according to MSNBC.
Your experts, your workers, about why people who are coming in the program, some of them with symptoms close to fatal, why they're not, why are they still not getting vaccinated?
There are several
are they
reasons.
Poor? Are they stupid?
The biggest reason we hear from patients and their families is that the vaccines are not approved. So I think that is creating a bit of dialogue that is mysterious. There's a patient certainly motivated by individual belief systems, whether they're personal.
And this little thing right here that was a micro away. But that's actually a scar from a dermatologist.
Did that certainly hear that pretty often.
They look real close, it looks like a little boob or something.
One, two, 5, 10 years. Is there a match memory?
I guess the good thing is the little whatever was on there that she blasted with the freezing cold spray went away. But it left a mark. I think she scarred me on purpose, frankly. And I think she scarred me on purpose right there, too, frankly. And so I'm treating that right now.
It's clearly a struggle, so I'll give you some data points. So our peak in the winter, which for us was in January, was 157 patients. This morning we're at 214. So that alone, even would suggest to you, new peak, maybe 30% higher, that's a challenge. But there's a bigger story here, which is 8 weeks ago, June 17th, we had 11 patients. And so there's this rapid and accelerated rise that's unprecedented.
And what
beginning. At the risk of being repetitive, this is a pandemic of the infection.
And what about your nurses and doctors?
Well, that's also the pandemic of the India people. Of the Indians, because it's the Delta variant, which they say originated in India. If this was last year, we'd be calling it the India variant. But now we've got the Alpha, Beta, Gamma, Delta system. Remember the quote unquote China virus? So now the Delta variant is now the DeSantis variant. They want to hide the fact that it came from India, and they want to pretend like it's
in touch with patients' families, and there's a line between patients and loved ones from a conversation perspective. And then they go home.
Got it.
They have to confirm with their home already, whether it's their spouse has a job or not, their family's company is open or not.
And they used to name viruses after the location. West Nile virus, Ebola.
Maybe all of us can imagine that.
The Spanish flu, but that was a misnomer.
Trying
to remember after the place it was
from.
I think they saw that as a weapon to mitigate, to try to like belittle the wherever it came from. And we live in such a connected world, and these things bounce around so much, and it's hard to sometimes to find out where they came from.
People in the state of Florida and to the governor of the state of Florida, what should be the mindset? How should people be thinking based on what you just described?
Well, so I spoke to the governor yesterday, and I'll tell you that he is certainly aware and open-minded to what we need to do. To our community, we have to really focus on vaccination, and we have to push strategy between now and then.
I'll be forced to just continue to be aware and do it. Community by community. If I understand this correctly, the governor said that they can't have mask mandates in Florida. I'm thinking it goes to everybody, not just government. So that means masks have to be optional, which is their prerogative. Some states are probably doing that already. Or at least in practice, that's what people all across America are doing. People don't have to follow the rules a lot, usually unless they're enforced, and sometimes they're not enforced, depending on where you go. Like here, if I want to go to the Greyhound station, they have a mask requirement, they want people wearing masks in there. And somebody said they're federal. Federal government has some kind of business inside of Greyhound. I don't know if he's telling the truth. I should follow up on that. But then if I go to CVS, they say no, masks are not required there. Well, if everywhere else, there's no mask requirements. The business is here.
How can you, as an expert, compel people to understand that the vaccine is safe?
So it's optional. Which seems wise, you know. If you live in a small town or city and COVID's not around, know it's not coming around, or if you live in this place where it already came around, there's reasons why you might not want to bother. There's a million reasons why, and nobody has to tell the reasons to anybody either. It's up to you what you want to do with your body. It's funny, they're dividing people right now based on pro-choice and anti-vax, because they think that everybody that is anti-vax is also anti-choice. Not me. And I don't really consider myself anti-vax, because I think that they were, to a degree anyway, for a while anyway, usually. And they've saved a lot of lives in other countries. But I'm pro-choice. And I'm pro-choice with the vaccine too. These people are pro-choice on the vaccine. Or I mean, they're pro-choice about having a baby, bring the fetus out of the womb or not. But they're anti-choice when it comes to vaccines.
All right, CEO of the University of Florida Health, Shams Ed Jimenez, thank you very much for coming on the show this morning. Good night.
We were just talking about Florida, where the governor is now threatening to withhold pay for education officials who enforce mask mandates for students. A statement from the governor's office warns Florida's Board of Education could quote narrowly tailor any financial consequences, citing salaries as an example. For district superintendents and county school board members who require masks this fall, taking away their salaries. Superintendent for Leon County responded defiantly, telling school officials at a meeting yesterday, quote, "You can't put a price tag on someone's life, including my salary." Leon is where several Florida counties, including Broward, Hillsborough, Palm Beach, and others, that already have announced mask mandates in public schools. And you can take politics out of this, forget what party the governor is from. This is just perverse. You're telling superintendents of school boards in school districts where there are outbreaks in South Florida that you cannot put masks on kids to protect them.
Can't make them wear masks. Right?
In our next hour,
no mask mandate. It doesn't mean you can't. Yeah, I guess it means you can't put a mask on a kid. That's what it means. If it ain't your kid, you can't mask. Sounds fair enough. You shouldn't be masking other children, other people's children. Ask your own damn children. Or don't. Yeah, you can't. I don't think. People are off the rocker. There's no counterpoint. They just run away with it. Off the deep end, they just ramble on and build onto their narrative every day. What a horrible, horrible life that must be. They are in an echo chamber, and they do preach to the choir. So they're back on 100%. That's the only thing he knows about people that are dying. Listen to that statement out of context. What a crazy statement. People are dying that are doing about hundreds of thousands of other things. At a much greater clip. Kids and hope for kids and how you can get your way. Everybody thinks if they just say the right words that people will obey them. Or they think if I just say the right words, the people that like me and think like me will agree with me. These people make money on being at odds with other people.
Biden needs a coherent strategy for the border. An excerpt reads like this: the convoluted messaging telling
traffic entry to the U.S. while at the same time relaxing the
traffic
entry
to
dissuade them and providing relief to migrants on both sides of the border has been a failure. That failure is measurable and it is politically toxic.
This appeals to old, scared conservative
people. And after Kamala Harris, too, they said she went down there to find the root causes. She comes back with a list of what they, what the region's problems are.
Pretty busy crossing. I've went into Mexico probably a dozen times.
Did
you see
him
on the border?
He says he's going to meet with the frontline workers, the lead officials, local officials, and community leaders.
Everyone down to Tijuana for everything, for a former wife's nose job, to shopping, to bar hopping, to La Revolucion, and dancing. Went to, took another girl down to Rosarito and Sonata with my fraternity to Sonata.
That is going to legalize possibly up to 8 million acres, which is going to count another million.
I drove to La Paz. That was a lot of fun. Border search goes at one degree of violence. Well, what it looks like is happening is the governor of Texas is stopping the immigration, and so people are piling up there at the border. So it might look like a surge, but it might just be people that haven't lined up for a while.
The Biden administration is intentionally and systematically.
But there's also Arizona and New Mexico. I haven't heard much from those. And there's California. California is run by Democrats, and so I don't think you're going to be able to criticize that one too much. Spanish is my second language.
Well, the second reason is because they want to turn Texas to Arizona. That's why they're going
to
It's really weird to hear people talk about immigrants and immigration in a negative light, because they came up with a lot of jobs that my friends didn't want to. You know, it's talking about people, immigrants taking jobs. Sometimes they have to, they're seasonal workers, these people from other countries that have full jobs. It's going to happen again, you know, if Americans don't take these jobs, they'll fill most of them. It's what happens.
The southern border by saying, let's put in more money to Central American nations. You just watch. They'll get at our checkbook and write checks to these countries.
That's probably what they should be talking to, whoever's not taking these jobs with the immigrants. I've heard the first generation immigrants that you know, normally work real hard.
Shows and stands up in a purple state for the people of Arizona, it seems. Mark Kelly, what is he doing? Except for sitting on the sideline while his state is being barraged.
I mean, how do you fight against old, these people when the old people with crazy views just dump money into their pockets? You know, how do you compete with that? Just, if you don't understand it, just try to imagine it.
Crazy
people. crazy views, don't stop supporting their people. And so that's why these assholes have confidence. Because they get good. They'll give up every view that they have real fast if they weren't making money. And chances are they don't even have these views anyway. They just reset. I'm sick of hearing this Cuomo thing, Jesus. I hate it when these stations play the same exact clips over and over again.
Joining us now, Maggie Haberman, CNN political analyst and Washington correspondent at the New York Times, who has covered all kinds of politics, including New York politics, for years. So Governor Cuomo was trying to buy time. What does time actually buy him?
Well, the price of more time, the governor's going to check him on other things. But look, what I think he's hoping to do, and again, I think where his head is very hard to believe at any given day. What he's hoping to do is, as time goes on, and he will down, there will be a number of Assembly Democrats who would have to vote for impeachment who he can get to not, who he can get to stay on the side. He doesn't really have a whole lot to work with right now. There's no budget that he can build things out. That's past me. There's no, strength that he can build out.
I think the only one might be waiting for him to say he's not going to run again for a fourth term. That'd be kind of like resigning. This comes from a political family. His dad was Mario Cuomo. So it's pretty embedded. I think that New York has so many different powerful people there. It's many people. I think that this might be vetted out appropriately. Even in his own party. Different factions. People trying to impress different people. Probably keep each other off balance.
So I think that's certainly an avenue. That does not mean that in the business conference we might be
able to do the power kind of power.
The lieutenant governor appears poised to kind of move in here once Cuomo is out, the expectation that the family isn't there for him. She's actually been marginalized.
In fact, he could have just done everything on his father's name and legacy.
I think it's been a good thing that she's made.
She's more independent than a lot of Democrats like.
She's not tied to any of this. She's not someone who's advice and so on. She doesn't show up over and over again in that Attorney General report as a number of people did. And she has been,
I didn't want to say it, but I heard somebody say it, and they said that the way that he was touching people was okay to his generation. And somebody else articulated a lot that, like, that stuff used to get from the people just got away with that in this generation. I don't know, I was taught that appropriate touching just is the arm down. Unless you're related to the person or your girlfriend's spouse.
So,
appropriate touching is just from the arm down. So that's how I live my life.
Testimony from Jeffrey Rose of the Senate Judiciary Committee, revelations about what Jeffrey Clark, who was a senior member of the Justice Department.
I don't want to touch my strangers, and I already pay strangers a favor by not touching them.
Inside Trump, these are things that the former president or his confidants fear.
So,
for any reason,
you know, I wouldn't tap it on somebody's shoulder or something like that.
It's a great look, it's a great question. Certainly around. So if you put that caveat out there, that's not what they really want. The reality is that with Congress's ability to chastise him, punish him, or inflict some kind of punishment to him is pretty limited. We saw that over and over again over the last 4 years. Trump really is more worried about his prosecution for more
ways. Vicious cycle sometimes when people don't come forward and complain and justice is not served. It's a vicious cycle.
Accountability on his attempts and his words to try to overturn an election could be a deterrent to someone in the future. I wonder how
big victims turn into sometimes I think victims turn into abusers.
affecting not him, but the country. Is it important to have something there?
I do think it's important for people to understand. I don't think that, I think this has faded from the public consciousness pretty extensively. In fact, you look at somebody who was really stress testing the existing system this is the checks and balances, this is just laws that are there. And what is supposed to happen at an election. So you could have somebody, Donald Trump is notoriously not very organized. You could have somebody who was more organized, who did understand the levers of power and the levers of government and how to use them. And he wanted to do some harm in an upcoming election, if not the next 4 years, let's say 8 years, let's say 12 years. They have a bit of a roadmap, right? And you might try to do that now. And so I think for that reason, that is why it's important to, if not in terms of accountability, in terms of literal punishment, but at least to inform the public and make people understand the importance of this.
Thank you. Great to see you. Thank you, Governor. All right, demand for fake vaccine cards on the rise as more and more companies mandate vaccinations. Are officials doing up the fight against the counterfeits?
Plus, we're going to introduce you to an Orlando PE teacher who survived a 72-day battle with coronavirus. His message.
No one's wife or husband is telling their kids that mom or dad may not come home.
Just slow down, man. Jesus Christ, dude. Just slow down. Can they just slow down? The vaccine's not even approved yet. Just it's so crazy. What's gonna happen? Like their way is the other way. My way or the highway?
I'm getting some deep.
I slow commercial. Got some peppermint tea. And we're brewing some green tea. We drink a lot of tea. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm fasting right now, so that's good. I may fast for a long time. It's been one day. Feels great, feels strong. Just not giving anything.
This morning, more than 50% of the country is fully vaccinated, and the number is increasing. It's risen 10% just last week. But as more companies and cities are mandating vaccinations, the demand for counterfeit vaccine cards also on the rise.
I was thinking about that.
Is with us now. So some people don't want to get vaccinated.
I don't care at all about this. It's bad, so listen to me. It's bad, do what I say. It was just bad. Bad. And it can be good, just do this. Pop this pill, slam this needle, you'll be good. Good, you'll be better. You'll be good, I promise you'll be good. Listen to her, you'll be good. Listen to him, you'll be good. You'll be great. You'll be okay. Come on, do what I say. Sound like the ounce of drugs, talking that way. That's how I'm going to be if I get that vaccine. They turn you into a rambling asshole.
He said from the superintendents across the state of Florida, you referenced one county, I'm going to reference one. This is from the superintendent of Miami-Dade. He said, at no point shall I allow my decision to be influenced by a threat to my paycheck. And it's not just Florida. I've heard the same from superintendents in Phoenix. And
really good. That's what that works.
Going to hear this for several weeks, and then I think we're going to hear it again as we head into 2022. This isn't about politics. This is about the health and safety of our
students, litigate if you have damage,
of our workers, and of our community. And local leaders are so desperate, Mika, to take politics out of the equation, and it keeps being injected over and over again by some of these leaders at the state level.
Yeah, we're hearing that in Dallas, too. Superintendent said the same thing. And by the way, this is not a far off.
I would be shocked if the Democratic Party doesn't write these paper checks and the GOP doesn't write
Fox checks. But if you step back on a human level, if you can, and just say Governor X from Party X is telling a superintendent in a school district where there's a spike in COVID case, and that superintendent is worried about his or her students inside the classroom for their safety, and that governor is saying, well, if you force them to wear a mask, if you protect them, I'm going to take away your salary, I'm going to take away funding from your school district. Again, that is sick. That is the worst whoever said
it.
And that's why, Lily, I would submit that this is the biggest, the most important story in the country right now. Because it is a story of ego and blind ambition, all encapsulated in one man, Ron DeSantis, a graduate of Yale University, Harvard Law School.
Pretty impalpable too. It's a lot of issues, man. There needs to be more live TV.
That is basically what he was saying and doing, all under the guise of ambition, his political ambition, running for higher office, aka the presidency, and also putting together a philosophy that government is too big.
I've never liked DeSantis more than I like him right this very
minute. I guarantee you that I will bet my children's lives, I will bet that Ron DeSantis will take as much money as he can grab out of the forthcoming public works bill, basically, that's going to pass the United States Senate and be signed into law.
If he signed an executive order that nobody can mandate masks, then we might be able to throw them in jail if they require masks for students. And not just take their salary, not just withhold their salary. We might be literally able to to have law enforcement go down there and throw them in jail. That's what happens when you disobey an executive order.
I couldn't agree with you more, Mike Barnacle, and in just a few moments, we'll be talking
they're gonna do that to people,
Dr.
You know,
Anthony
and
Fauci about
the mayor,
and a lot more as the Delta
executive order, they
continues to rip through
take
this country.
As far as I
and coming up, the Taliban makes new advances
governors.
In Afghanistan as U.S. troops prepare
well, the problem
to
is there's
withdraw
no,
at the end of the month.
There's no real state jail that I know of, or state police force.
Belarus,
there's state troopers. The mayor has ordered the sheriff and the police. The governor, I suppose, can too. But that's not really how it works. I think the governor can make the executive order, but then it has to be enforced. You know, depending on the political affiliation of the district, the city, or county, it may or may not be enforced. And then, if it's not enforced, then it's either not going to be enforced, or it's got to be somebody else enforcing it, or resources given to somebody to enforce it. Terrible people.
Really hard to balance. I have a 10-year-old, and he would try to rush through, and of course, they have the gadgets, and they were playing games. So, with my job, it was really nice. My employer was flexible, but I did work about 16-hour days. I'm used to traveling for work, so I was home remotely, and it was really hard having children there making noise and having a hard time finding a go that was quiet to do video calls. And then checking on them in between and making sure they were doing their academic work, which was definitely far behind them they would have done in their classroom.
Right. And Jamie, I know that you decided to leave your job. You were a project analyst at an engineering company. You decided to leave when your first child was born. You have two sons. And then you wanted to go back to work. And then the pandemic hits. So how has that affected you? Are you going to be able to go back to work, or are you waiting to see how this Delta variant plays out?
I'm waiting to see how the variant plays out. In May this year, the restrictions were loosening up, the job market's hot, even in my local area, there is analyst jobs 10 minutes from my house, which is pretty unusual because most jobs like that are in New Jersey or Cherry Hill area, North Jersey. So
this should probably increase the federal minimum wage. States make their own, but it's pretty low. It hasn't been increased for a very long time. Some industries suffer a lot. Some people working for some industries in some states tend to suffer.
And then,
and just, I don't know, $15 is the right number, but it would be interesting to have the same exact minimum wage across the whole entire country. They do now, but like I said, states can raise it, and they do. That would make it.
So I would imagine if anybody
I think that would make,
school,
I don't think any state has higher than
$15. But now that virtual
now
school is back
wage.
On the table,
so
just from that
all
survey
alone,
I imagine they're not writing it off
completely. Be pretty cool.
I believe that
and people might
want
to travel more or feel inclined to
potentially go back to work,
right? Take risks
so
or other jobs.
It's scary to be able to know what the future holds. Your husband's a state trooper, he's also in the National Guard, so he's working two jobs.
In less desirable jobs. I thought about the big burden that is or will be on businesses.
Really
it's my dad's
sure
business owner, I'm a business owner. That's obviously
yes,
asking for a good
number
too. Businesses can't just make money out of thin air. They're going to fire people or raise prices or something like that.
Always worked from home, so
maybe
my life was chaos even before all of this, but the craziness has just taken on a whole new life. And
make more money.
You know, I'll never forget that day when I got the call from school that my oldest daughter Stella had been exposed and had
to do it.
Quarantine for an indefinite amount of time. I have to go pick her up immediately.
Just
I was standing in my kitchen with my baby strapped to me.
But if everybody starts making
and
more money,
just drop
in your
everything
city,
and go get her. And I know that some
you can maybe raise prices
and
start
that
way
and
more business.
And just go through the motions.
But that's the thing, that's the obvious
and,
thing that's probably going to happen if they raise the minimum wage, is that prices are going to go up.
Moms throughout the country because there's
and
so
these political parties fight so much,
and
Trump's going to run again. And he's too old. People don't really want to see him anymore. And there's a big opposition. Across the gamut, really. But I think that they'll keep trying to cultivate his power. And he might even have to run in the primary. And maybe endorse somebody else. They might give him the chance to do that and bow gracefully after they defeat him in the primary.
Only one party in the United States is
it's hard to tell.
And that would be
things keep changing, and that's a little
party.
Ways off.
Yeah. I mean, the Republican Party. We get my point.
I get the point, and that's absolutely right. And that's why even Max's thesis that Biden is best off in the country, best off if he stays centrist.
I just can't stand listening to him anymore. He doesn't do a good job. He doesn't do a good government. He doesn't know what he's doing. He just reads stuff. He doesn't listen. He's brash. He attacks nice people. He has wonky views. He wants to take America back to the Stone Age. He doesn't have the right views or progressive views. He's pretty much a goddamn nightmare and a fucking disaster. Identity, the way he talks, the way he walks.
This
shit up and down.
The Democratic Party has to fill the role of the entire political spectrum, from AOC to Joe Manchin, and we somehow muddle through. And so, what is being centrist in this environment? I'm not sure. So far, it seems like whatever Biden's doing is working pretty well, and now that it looks like he is going to get infrastructure through somehow, and the Senate's going to work on human infrastructure, it looks like maybe he's on
the apparently the budget infrastructure deal at $1.5 trillion is not going to have any of the environmental climate, whatever, renewable perks in it, but the $3.5 trillion will. So apparently we were going to go straight into that one for this one and start negotiating for it. I'm saying it might pass on party lines, so if that happens, I think the Senate might be tied 50-50, and then Kamala Harris would have to come in and make the tie a breaking vote. People have their pet issues and their buddies, and they want to juice them up first, and then they usually think about everybody else.
Some people have a tendency to underestimate his sense of awareness of where he is.
So when Biden was running for president, I wanted to know who he is.
He knows for certain
who has he made deals with over the last 3 years. He's been in government for decades. Who does he owe favors to?
How to deal with those internal mechanical personal levers in the United States Senate. I think he's underestimated because I
another interesting thought is what in the world happened on January 5th. I was trying to do some research. Because if somebody knew what was going to happen on January 6th and had enough power and wanted to do something else and get away with it, they would probably make him come down on January 5th.
Law, and increase employment as well. But underestimating Joe Biden, you do that at your peril. He's a quiet, confident guy, and he knows what he's doing, and he knows what he wants.
You know, he loves what he's doing, and he loves connecting with people, and he loves politics, and he loves, he was served in the Senate,
from the same burnout among nurses and facing staffing shortages as infections surge again. All of this preventable. Dr. Anthony Fauci joins our conversation at the top of the hour.
I heard Fauci talk earlier. Oh, he was on, I saw Fauci talk on the Rachel Maddow show, but I only listened to the repeat while I was doing stuff. It actually just makes me a little bit sad how these people are so one-dimensional, you know. Just pathetically one-dimensional. Okay, so 30 officers turned around against Lightfoot. Protested. I said it was a little more than a dozen. It didn't look like 30 that I saw. But 30. CNN said 30. Which is so, like I said, these people tend to be so freaking one dimensional. It's sad. They remind me of like, you know, one tool players. Like the anti cult apologists at the church I went to. You know, it's like, kind of like, wow, you know, when that gets to be your thing, it makes you into a sort of a strange person. Not so well-rounded anymore. And maybe just because you're too laser-focused on that one thing, and it becomes everything. It just can't become everything. I like sleeping days. Stations spin everything. Right now, Fox News is showing a video of a woman dancing and having fun, and she's a Democrat, and they're using it against her to say she doesn't have masks. She don't wear a mask. She's a bad person. And she's one of the quote unquote squad members. They hate them the most. Just makes you like want to go take a shower after hearing that. Wonky words about people they don't like. Serious, serious issues. WAPO rips White House for convoluted messaging on border. Maybe they see that the conservatives are burning with this issue, and it could possibly be an election time issue that they could use to generate whatever to fight the Democratic people from getting elected. Because WAPO's liberal, and the White House is liberal. So if WAPO's ripping them for convoluted messaging on border, they're telling them to come up with a plan, because or else it's going to be used against them. Because Dem's talking about COVID and other stuff, and Fox keeps, might be connecting with somebody over this nonsense. They just put Juice by Lizzo on the way out, Fox News. Thanks. Anyway, it's sad how there's actual real literal human beings that I've seen and talked to you on both sides of the border, and then these suits here, just like, I think it's a political gambling chip. Well, good luck. I support your freedom and your choice, whatever it is. When it comes to your body, I wish somebody else would be consistent instead of being a fair weather choice.